Here's a fiberglass door off a motorhome that somebody hit. I'm gonna cut that damaged area out. I put a couple of pieces of matting together last night and soaked them in the fiberglass resin. And I'm gonna trim that out, angle it, trim this out to fit, angle it, resin it in, grind over the whole top, and probably either I'm gonna put another little piece of matting down or just go rot repair. And then I have to somehow match this faded dead thing and make it look the same. Okay, when cutting fiberglass, mask, goggles, paint suit, cover your hair. You don't want this stuff in your skin pores, especially if you're sweating. Okay, so I made a template. It goes around this area. And now I'm going to notch this out at an angle this way. And then I'm going to do the same thing with this. And I'm going to notch it out the same way so it just kind of locks in. And could have made a square, but I don't really like putting squares on flat panels. I like to round things off. And there's the little patch sealed in. I added a couple more pieces of matting here and there. I could have just thrown matting in the damaged hole and stuffed it, but I just kind of like to make a repair. Okay, there's the patch. That's the replacement area. Now I'm gonna grind this out, take it down below the surface, about an eighth of an inch, coat it with rot repair, we call it, short strand fiberglass. And I'm just gonna use this body file to make sure it's all below the surface. And then I'll do probably light plastic after that. And then I get to match a faded gel coat. And there's the short strand fiberglass. Smooth that out, some light plastic after that. And there's the fiberglass all sanded out with 80 grit. Did it all with a DA. I'm gonna go light plastic now and I'll be blocking that initially with 80.
How are you doing?
Well, so it's the beginning of a repair on a fiberglass door or something to an old motorhome. What I've done just now is I 320'd out beyond the area that I'm going to prime. I laid down three coats of a filler primer, two-part. And tomorrow I'm going to use what we call a color map to try and get some kind of a shade close to that, because I got to match a faded old gel coat. And then I'm just going to blend it out into the rest of the panel and throw a coat of matte clear down like I used on my Jeep. And that's going to be that. We'll see how that goes.